Everyone, my name is Loretta Roger, and thanks for joining me today with Stamping with Loretta. Today I'm going to show you a project that I'm very proud of that I've been working on this last week. I'd also like to tell you that I'm sorry it's been a while since I posted a video. I have been busy. As many of you know, my husband has been deployed forward in Afghanistan for the last 5 months, and he is home. Thank God, praise the Lord, for a few more days before he has to return to Afghanistan. So we've enjoyed our time together, and while he's been gone, I've actually gotten quite a few things done around the house that I'd been wanting to do for a long time, and organizing pantries and linen closets and silly stuff like that, and of course stamping. So I do want to show you what I've been making. This project is actually for Max, our little grandson, who we finally got to meet just a short few weeks ago. He is absolutely gorgeous. So hi, Max. I have no idea what the little fellow's gonna call me. He can call me anything he wants as long as he lets me kiss his toes. So you know how that is. So this project is for Max. I'm going to be sending it to his mom. Here's the front cover. Now, a couple of things about this. This is the AccuCut Build an Album camera die. This is for use in the Grandmark machine for you guys who know about that. So I'm going to adjust my camera down so that I can show you this a little bit better. Alright folks, here's the little mini that I made for my grandson Max. The front cover, like I said, the whole album is the Build an Album from AccuCut, the camera one. And I'm hoping this comes out because I don't want to film it twice. This is actually the new Sizzix die called Picture Wheel. It is basically like the old picture wheels that you used back in the day when I was a kid. It's on an action wobble, so you can see that. And I decorated the front cover with just some cute little die cuts. And then the first page is just little Max. This is right after he was born. This was his first bath. I don't know the date, so I left the dates blank for his mom to fill in. And then there's some more pictures of the little guy. And this die has this film strip in it. I just cut out some pictures from the collage sheet that I had requested when I had the pictures printed to begin with, and used those of Granddad meeting the little guy. And then here's my husband with Max. Oh, they're both very handsome, so I have no complaint. The men in my life are just wonderful. I am continuing to do well. I do get lots of questions asking how I'm doing because I haven't posted in a while. I've gained back a few pounds, mostly because my husband has been feeding me while he's been home. I'm sure they'll come right back on off, but it's just a thing for now. But here's a picture of me and the little guy. And the paper I used are just from, most of it's Paper Studio or stuff that I had in my stash already. Here's Max, who was maybe a day old in this picture. And then here's my husband. Here's a full-size picture wheel from Sizzix. It is actually also on an action wobble, so he can play with it, I guess. And some more pictures of him with his grandpa. And then here's Cereal Face, my little Gerber baby. If you've looked at my blog, this picture is on my blog. He is adorable. And then here, we wrote little Max a note, and we both signed it, so he'll have something from to see in the future. And I didn't really finish the back cover, and I did this to the binding. It's just real simple. I've also done quite a bit of shopping in the last few weeks. My husband was very gracious to take me to 3 different stamp stores in the San Diego area, and I loved it. We had such a wonderful time. The last place we stayed was called the Stamping Attic, and next time I go up there, I'm going to give her a little week or two notice, and I will be teaching classes there. I haven't decided what I'm going to teach yet. I'm kind of leaning towards some fun mini books, something that I can have everything done and just mail it to her and then do the class. So if you're in San Diego, in that area, then go see the Stamping Addict. It is worth the trip to that store. The staff was extra friendly. The people even shopping in the store were really nice. The area is breathtakingly beautiful. We couldn't have asked for better weather while we were gone, and we just had a really great time. So, and I'm also gonna do a quick little video response here while I got ya. For some of the tag questions, they are fun, ladies and gentlemen, that you guys have been posting. My most embarrassing moment, a lot of you will not even understand, but some of you might, so I'm going to tell you what it was. I was about 15, and back then I was a Rainbow Girl, and Rainbow is a fraternal organization sponsored by Master Masons and the Order of Eastern Star for women. And so I was a Rainbow Girl. That's how I grew up. And I treasure those memories to this day so much. I just loved it. But we were having an initiation. And I had to go up the stairs to the platform where the advisor was sitting, and I lost my shoe in the middle of the ceremony and had to continue on the rest of it without the shoe until somebody went to get it. And so somebody actually just kind of handed me my shoe from the sideline. So that's one of my most embarrassing moments ever. I've had some others, but that's the one that stands out in my mind. What do I like to do other than stamp and scrapbook? I love to read. I have a Kindle and I also have an iPad, so those are great tools for reading. I read more now than I used to because I do have those. I keep them, charged. When they start dying, they're back on the charger because I'm going to read. I actually also like to do housework. I know that sounds crazy, but I take a great pride in our home, and it means something to me to know that at any time someone could come to our door and I would feel wonderful about having them come in, because my house is for the most part neat. Now right now I'm telling you it's a hot mess. Even mine's a hot mess with things going on with Mike. So that's just what it is. Let's see, what else? Favorite things? Of course, my die cutting machines are my favorite tools right now. Other favorite things? Of course, my husband and my son, they're my world. And that's about it. So on this little side note here, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you thank you so much. I am almost at 600 subbies. It amazes me that you guys would subscribe. I'm so glad you like what I put out there. If you want to see something new, a video tutorial of some kind, then please email me. I'll make sure that information is on the blog, as well as maybe down below if I remember to put it there. But I am going to be doing a 600 subbie giveaway, so you guys need to watch out for that. It's going to be real soon, so I hope to be able to shoot a video and do a giveaway. So go ahead and start just posting anywhere on my blog, my YouTube channel, or Facebook to congratulate the 600 subbies, and I'll be announcing what the prize is going to be in my next video, so be looking for it. Now keep in mind, if you're seeing this YouTube video after February the 20th, then they're between February 20th, 2013 and March 1st, 2013, chances are the giveaway is completely finished, but I hope you enjoyed the video anyway. Hey, by then I might have 1,200, who knows, right? So, anyway, 600 subbie giveaway is coming up soon. I will be giving away a spectacular prize package and some die cuts and all that, and if you want a list of my current dies that I have available, please just email me and I'll be glad to send that to you as an attachment. There are 3 files and they're all very, very large. So I appreciate each and every single one of you. I hope you all continue to do well, and I hope that you are truly blessed by the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Take care, everyone. Thanks for joining me. Stamp happy. Be a blessing. I'll talk to you soon.
A house fly swimming in my sweet tea. Hey, darling, pass another curd jar to me. Butter dripping off a biscuit, baby, better take a bite. Cantaloupe thumps like it's finally right. Box fan on a lawn chair, sucking in swamp air. 200-mile marker signs from nowhere. That's what country is. It ain't a red little flag you bought at the mall. It's a highway. Getting caught stealing a Boone's Farm kiss. It ain't a John Deere cap that's never fell in the cotton. It's a Jimmy Rogers song that was long forgotten. It's homemade peach ice cream on sunburnt lips. That's what country is. When the sun starts slipping from the Delta sky and the last scarecrow tucks in for the night, make a fire, throw a blanket on the sandy bank. Bide an hour till we feel the first catfish yank. Barefoot cane pole waving at the river boats. And when they're gone, take a dip in the moon glow. That's what country is. It ain't a rebel flag you bought at the mall. It's a hideaway bed in an old horse stall. Two kids getting caught stealing a Boone's Farm kiss. It ain't a John Deere cat that's never fell in the cotton. It's a Jimmy Rogers song that was long forgotten. It's homemade peach ice cream on sunburned lips. That's what country is. On sunburned lips. No, it can't be bought. It's something you're born with. That's what country is. That's what country is. That's what country is. That's what country is.